we are, they are, it's very, they are very, very beautiful person. We really reach very, very profound. And it's exactly the kind of things that we need to discuss. I would say that in Mexico, like in the United States, more and more people are signing that document to have the protection against the system. I want to die well, not to die in a hospital tube and tubicle or these kind of things. Then I want to die at home and be cared by my family and my loved ones. To have a decent kind of decent death. One way of saying this is that we are trying to look, again, Illich said this beautiful, what we are trying to reclaim is the art of living and dying. And it is the same, it is not two different kind of things. It is not the art of living well and then the art of dying. It is the same kind of things. You know how to live well, you will know how to die. And of course, we lost that opportunity. And of course, I cannot avoid discussing anything without stories. I have my story about these kind of things. My grandmother, 96 years old, she was Zapotec. She did not have any known disease. Sometimes when she had some specific pains in the knees, she was putting the knees close to the wall with the gesso, and then after half an hour she was better, and that was all the things that she needed. She loved fiestas, and she loved to go to every fiesta. And one specific year, she started to go to every fiesta for every kind of things, and saying in the fiesta, this is my last marriage, or this is my last Christmas, or this is my last baptism, or whatever. But it was not blackmailing the others. It was, this is my last, then I need to enjoy it much. And then she was really celebrating and dancing and doing everything because she wanted to enjoy that, the last Christmas. Then when the whole cycle of fiestas ended, she invited to the house of my mother some of her favorite granddaughters and granddaughters and grandsons, and she prepared a very nice meal for us that evening. And at the end of this dinner, we remember later that she said goodbye in a very special way. She kissed all of us, and then she went to bed. And she died during the night. For us, it was, for me, it's a perfect example of knowing when to die. She knew that the time has come. I have a beautiful, magnificent life. I am at the end of it. Let's celebrate whatever I can celebrate. And when it is ended, that's it. Then let's say goodbye and abandon the planet in a very peaceful way. That is the art of dying, that they knew very well. Really, it is some famous person, I don't remember whom, said that the fear to die is not to be afraid of death, but afraid of not having lived. Meaning my life was empty, and my life was clearly without any meaning. But then I am trying to continue living to see if something happens that gives some meaning to my life. Then this really, to know how to die is to know how to live, is the art of living and dying. If I am living, I am living my life, I have a meaning in my life, then I will not be afraid of dying, because the life itself has a meaning. And part of the meaning of the life is death. It's embedded in life, this perception of death. There is something else. Please don't take this information seriously. It's highly controversial. Two Indian doctors in India, from India, 30 years ago, produced fantastic research on cancer. And they had an alternative theory of cancer. And then they said that cancer is basically a form of senescence, that with a few of senescence, aging, they say this is the worst kind of affirmation, say no one dies of cancer. people die with cancer. Many people, most people can have a cancer. And the body, with a few exceptions that they identify very, very well, the body finds a way to deal with the cancer, with a tumor or whatever, in a spectacular way. They did two pieces of research.